Hey, what's going on, guys? So today we're gonna look at a few games, and if you bought yourself a pre-built computer, more than likely that computer came with one of these. A single, not very fast, stick of RAM. Now, a single stick is fine. Your computer's gonna run, and your games will probably run decently well. Now, the difference is that for an extra $30, you can buy yourself another stick of this. And the performance gains that you can get
are pretty substantial.
So what we're gonna do today is we're gonna check out a number of games and comparing one 8GB stick to two 8GB sticks. So there will be the metric of increased memory capacity, but also the ability to run in dual channel. So DDR4, double data rate, allows your memory to run at essentially double the speed and deliver a lot more performance. Most games don't use more than 8 gigs, so it'll simply just be, for the majority, the speed increase. However, there are a couple of games that will benefit from the extra couple of gigs that it needs. So we'll highlight that in the video. If you're not sure if you should get another stick of RAM, you'll definitely want to watch this, and then you can make your own informed decision. All right, let's check it out. Starting off with Grand Theft Auto, we saw a 16 frame increase, or an 8.9% increase going from single to dual channel. That's a pretty respectable difference, and it had little to do with the increased RAM capacity since it didn't even use 8 gigs. Next we've got Shadow of the Tomb Raider. Here we saw an 18 frame increase, or an 18.6% frame increase. This is pretty substantial considering all it is a $30 part. The benefit of dual channel was pretty apparent in this game. Though it ran well with single channel, it ran very well with dual channel. It's worth noting that this game did not use more than 8 gigabytes of RAM, so this difference came solely from the speed increase. Next, The Division 2 saw a 6 frame increase, or 8.1% increase going from single channel to dual channel. This difference was a little bit smaller than some of the others, which is actually quite surprising because this game does use more than 8 gigabytes of RAM, and yet the difference wasn't really that big. With Counter-Strike Global Offensive, we saw a 21 frame, or 7% frame rate difference going from single channel to dual channel. This game is very dependent on CPU speeds, it seems, and considering we were using the same CPU for both tests, it's not a surprise that the difference was not that great. Being in dual channel did, however, allow you to stay much closer to the 240 range, which would be very important if you're playing competitive on a 240Hz monitor. Next, we tested the newest installment of the Call of Duty series, Modern Warfare. We had a 14 frame increase, or an 11.8% increase. This is not too bad considering how new of a game it is, and so that 14 frames actually makes a pretty big difference when you're around that 100 frame mark, especially if you have a 144Hz or 240Hz monitor. Next, we tested Apex Legends. Apex Legends actually had the smallest increase at 6.9%, or 12 frames per second. This was a little bit surprising, but it ended up running really well with the single channel and only slightly better with dual channel. This game used under 8 gigabytes of RAM, so all the frame rate differences was from strictly the speed of dual channel. The next game we tested was PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds. In this game, we had a 14 frame difference going from single to dual channel, which equals 10.6%. This is pretty important because going from that 132 frames to 146, we break the 144 threshold, so those of you using a 144Hz monitor can get full benefit. Overwatch was by far the most impressive difference. In Overwatch, we saw a 98 frame per second increase, which is equal to 36.2%. This can be pretty important in a competitive context if you have a 240Hz monitor, because with the single channel, it often dropped below 240, but with the dual channel, it never dropped below. So as you saw, an extra one of these does make a difference. We saw frame rate increases as high as 98 frames per second in Overwatch. We saw 21 in CSGO, and anywhere from 10 to 20 in most other games. The Division didn't really get much advantage from the extra memory or from the extra speed, which is a little surprising, with only 6 frames per second average higher. But overall, we had a 14% increase in average frame rate. That, for an extra $30, is $30 for 14% is pretty amazing. So in all, if you bought yourself a pre-built, there's nothing wrong with that, but
upgrade your RAM, get yourself another stick.
It doesn't have to be pretty, just get yourself another stick and you'll be laughing. Anyways, thanks for watching. If you liked the video, hit that like button. If you want to see more, hit the subscribe button. And we'll have more coming to you soon.